Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Today I'm in Royal Forest and the autumn is coming very fast. You can see the leaves on the trees are yellow and soon they will fall off and the forest will be a little bit lighter. But I'm in a spruce forest now and I just made my fire and I'm going to make my coffee a little bit later. First I want to make a little lunch. I prepared some food from back home and I will cook this over the fire now.
Yeah, so. And the food I'm going to prepare over this fire, it has to be amber, so cold down here and no flame. So now I'll let it die out and only have these little coals to heat my delicious lunch.
And today I brought my little eating bowl. I'll use that today, but look at this. It's going to be that way, I think. Yeah, it's Yggdrasil from North Mythology, and in here some signs that are also related to Viking Age and Odin. Yeah, now I'm going to prepare my food here, and yeah, what do I have with me? Onion, some mushrooms, bell pepper and some small tomatoes coming up. Yeah, I'm going to use these sticks to put over the fire, and of course I won't be without any meat, so there's a little sausages here. I'll take some something on here we can't use. Yeah. Something like that. Then start with a piece of meat, perhaps a little tomato, some onions, a little mushroom. Yeah, have to be careful with those because they split very easily. I have to drill it and very carefully. Oh yeah, that's nice. And a little bell pepper. Like this, a little piece of meat, then I think, yeah, very nice. Make another one. And drill it. Yeah. Some onions, perhaps like this. Oh yeah, and a little tomato. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, then I just have to wait. I don't know if there's heat. Yeah, I think it's heat enough. Enough heat here. Mm-hmm. Looking delicious.
I just put some fire, some wood in, so I can bring up the heat, but I have to be very careful now. And I have one left here. I'm going to put on. Perhaps I'm going to prepare my coffee. Oops.
Watch out there, Tom. So now the coffee, the water for the coffee is ready. Yeah, and now it's very close to be finished. I'll just take it over. Yeah, this one can do a little bit more. What about this? Yeah.
Oh yeah. And this one.
So delicious. Then of course I'm going to use my little Viking stick for eating this meal. Oh yeah. Mmm. Very delicious.
Yep. Finished. Just let it rest for a minute or two. Yeah. Yeah, and I just want to show you this knife I got from Grimfrost. It's called the Raven. I bought it myself. I didn't get it as a review. I think it's a cool little knife, or a little. It's a cool knife, and well, the only thing I did was to change the handle. I didn't like it. It was very thin leather, and it didn't fit it as good as I can make it here, so, but it's still a great little knife, and you can see a raven head there on both sides. Yeah, And I sharpen it because it's not that's very sharp from the factory or from Grimfrost, but it's easy to sharpen. And yeah, I think it performs very well. It's carbon steel. I like that. And hand forged. So it's just my kind of knife here. I love it very much. And although it's a big knife, it's not very heavy. Very primitive, very cool in knife. And I have this on my belt. So, and as you saw in the beginning, I have made some addition to my Viking backpack frame. So I'd like to tell you a little bit about that project too. So hang on. Yeah, and it is this bag that I made for my rucksack. I made a closing like this little piece of birch wood, and in here I can have, as you saw, a lot of stuff. I can have my my kettle and my bushbuck stove, a whole lot of things, and I need that if I'm going to use the backpack frame more, because I want to have stuff with me so I can make food out here, and of course coffee and so on. So, and I made it, I don't know if you can see, a little bit wider in the bottom, so it fits the rucksack frame very well. And I think the way I close it here is also old school. I like it, and it fits nicely on top of my backpack frame. And I also made this little cross here to make the frame a little more rigid, so it doesn't wobble. It wasn't actually a problem, but I think maybe it could be later. I don't know. I don't think it makes it more beautiful, but I like it because it makes it more stable. And also, when I have small stuff on top, that don't fall through here. So that was the reason why I made this. I can always take it off if I want, but now it's very rigid, and I love it very much. And some of you have asked me if it's hurting when I'm walking with this, and actually it's very nice. You can see here I made a bend here with my hip and here with my shoulders. So when I'm wearing this, it's actually very comfortable to walk with. And I have about 10 kilos load on this, and that's not particularly much, but yeah, it's what I need. I have my wool blanket with me if it's going to be cold here, but instead of that I can have a little my lavo or something else, so I could make an overnighter here. Yeah, but I like it.
Yeah. And I got this little sharpening stone. It's Belgic block, I think it's called. It's a natural stone, and it's not cheap, I can tell you. So, but it's very good. There actually is two that are glued together. I just took them apart, so I have one with me. The other one is a little bit more coarse grind than this. This is fine, but it's good when I'm just maintaining my tools out here. And I just made this a little, very simple, primitive little sheet for it, so it doesn't make marks on my stuff down in my perch, a little belt back. So, a little thing I bought here in Denmark, Belgisch block, I think it's called. And did you notice that I have sharpened my axe from back home? It's much more durable now. I can cut in larger branches without any problems. I love this little axe, hand forged and Viking axe.
Well, folks, this was all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video where I showed my new addition to my backpack frame, Viking, and some other stuff. It's been a wonderful day out here. The weather is just marvelous. A little bit sunshine in between the clouds, but it's warm and no wind at all. So it's a really cool place, this little forest. I've never been in this part before, and I'll certainly be back here. Yeah. Hope you're having a nice weekend, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.